Remember the equation y equals to ax squared plus bx plus c. We always look at this. Maximum power of x is 2. We call this type of equation quadratic. So whenever we talk about quadratic, it's an equation with x squared. The biggest number power here is 2. So this quadratic that we learn, learn how to solve. Okay, last year, we learned how to solve by using factorization. Let me recall, what is factorization? So usually it becomes something like that. Factors. Remember this or not? So when this thing is no longer y, it's a 0. Do you remember how to solve? We just put x plus 2 equal to 0. X equals to negative 2. Then or x minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, this is the basic one. However, you can still refresh, revise this again. And we have so many methods to solve. Completing the square. It's slightly a bit hard to understand this, but once you understand, you can just write out everything. So this one is exam's favorite. Third method is by using quadratic formula. Gotta memorize this formula. Usually this formula is able to solve everything, including this type, the one that you factorize. And it also can solve the answers you get in the end with the irrational, full of decimals. And last part, the way to solve quadratic equation is by using graphs. Let's start from the easiest, which you have learned. Do you remember how to do factorization? On the second page, I tried to recall with you how to do factorization. First way is by finding common factors, right? 4a minus 2. How do I factorize this? All have 2. So take out a 2 and what do we have inside? 2a minus 1. Okay, divide by 2. Divide by 2, you get 2 and minus 1. Step 2. If you don't have common factors or you have already, move on to step 2. 3 terms is the quadratic equation. 1, 2, 3. 3 terms. You want to solve this? You do either your box method or your cross method. And the third method, whenever you see this, it will become a plus b, a minus b. Last one, we call it grouping method, remember? Grouping is 4 terms.
2x minus 2y plus 3x minus 3y.
1, 2, 3, 4. Then you just group 2 by 2. Okay, the first two group together by taking a common factor. Second group together, I take out common factor. Then you combine these two and combine, not this one. This one is common, so you just write it up. It becomes like this. So this is grouping. As long as you see it's 4 terms, we do that. Sometimes I require you to come for extra practice. Example, if I find that you have problem with factorization, because this topic requires your knowledge of factorization, to keep practicing, maybe next lesson you have to come 1 hour earlier. Then do the first picture practice. So now we start factorizing the equations. How to factorize 3 terms? So either cross or box. So in the end it will become like that.
Thank you.
answers you have?
One only. Completing the square always consists of two parts. One part is bracket square. Another part is a like to write it this way. Y equals to x plus h plus k. In the questions of exam, they always like to represent with alphabets in this way. Firstly, you have to understand how to form this way using quadratic equation. Let me explain to you what happens if you have such. Okay, if your quadratic equation look like completing the square, how do we solve? Step 1, the numeral move over to the other side. This one. If your p is negative number here, you must put the square with a, you must put bracket. Okay? Because in your calculator, if you don't put bracket, it means something else already. It means negative numbers. The negative should be inside the square.